just a minute. To see a world in a grain of sand and a heaven in a wildflower. Hold. World in a grain of sand. That's what I got. I didn't get the rest of it. A world in a grain of sand? Seriously? See this world in a grain of sand? Be some sad sand for a lot of people.
The car's on fire, and there's no driver at the wheel. And the sewers are all muddied with 1,000 lonely suicides. And a dark wind blows. And we're on so many drugs with the radio on and the curtains drawn. We're trapped in the belly of this horrible machine. And the machine is bleeding to death. The sun has fallen down, and the billboards are all leering, and the flags are all dead at the top of their poles.
Thank you.
Well, the first thing that I did was to make a beginning. But how do you visually study that which cannot be seen? Well, you need a model. So I built a model of my unconscious mind. I got an old drawer, filled it full of ordinary riverbank sand and everything that went with it. And I decided, with no conscious plan, to see what my hands would unconsciously make, to fashion, as it were, a visual model of my unconscious mind. This is my method, then, my beginning, to consciously sift sand until that which I sift for may stop unconsciously sifting me. Rather bizarre landscape, I know. Hodgepodge. The mine, I call it.
Okay, so I said, boys, we're going to do a quiet activity in the cafeteria. I said, I have it all set up, and the staff, Mr. Garrison, is going to tell you which yoga mat you go on. And I said, there's a bowl of sand. There's a box. And you're going to take the pebbles out of the sand and put them in the box. And we're going to I had some soft music playing, and you know, they were like all excited. And one of the boys, who is originally from Hawaii but lives in Vegas, said, did this sand come from Hawaii? And I said, could be, you know, why should I bust his bubble? And so they were looking for stuff, and they were seeing jewels, you know, they were all looking for shells in the sand, and some of them found some shells in the sand, and they saw crystals and all kinds of things. One of the boys got a little antsy, and like I told Barb the other day, had I been with it and not attached to it being a quiet activity, I would have sat with him. The next time I do it, I will do it in a circle. And we will do breathing exercises first, just to calm down. Because he was overwhelmed with all of the rocks that were in the sand and didn't think he could do it. So he started to play maracas with the sand. And I said, the next person that shakes it is mine. But one of the boys said, so the other staff person and I were going around putting initials on their containers because they were gonna take these back with them. And it needed to be identified so they could put it in their activity box. One of the boys said, I don't want to keep mine. I said, are you sure? He said, no, I don't want to keep mine. And then he said, I want to give this to my mom. And I said, well, then I have to put your initials on the box. Because if you were going to keep it,
hello. Is there anybody in there?
One of the boys who is very,
just not if you can hear me. Is there anyone at home? Come on now. I hear your feelings down. Well, I can ease the pain and get you on your feet again. I need some information first. just the basic facts. Can you show me where it hurts?
Treasure in the sand. So, you know, and they brought their sand back to them. They wanted different containers because they wanted them to separate the nice rocks from the other rocks. However, I didn't have enough containers for them, so I gave them a cup to do that. So that's the story.
I've sifted pebbles from play sand between index finger and thumb, thousands of pebbles, for about 3 years now. The original idea was to mine my unconscious mind. I found the hodgepodge and just plain bizarre. I found an unconscious path to rid my conscious mind of useless things. I found how to let go of useless things. My idea was to connect with myself through sifting the pebbles from the sand, to leave somehow my energetic imprint upon the pebbles, and then to keep the pebbles as proof of the time I had spent getting back in touch with myself. My pebble collection means everything to me, because every pebble proves something to me personally. That is, here is proof of the time I have spent reconnecting with me. Telling a person like me, young or old, just to calm down That's like telling an insomniac, just get some sleep. How many times through the years have I wanted more than anything? Just to calm down, but I couldn't. I just couldn't. Then through some grace, I started sifting sand. I feel instantly present, calmer, and happy even when I sift. Instantly, all of the above when I sift. That's amazing to me. Man, I sifted 200 pounds of Niangua River sand in the winter of 13. And in the summer of 15, I started sifting, private reasons. I felt joy from sifting.